Ladies and gentlemen, once more I come bearing a Gotham Season 4 video. So around a couple of weeks ago, I uploaded a video discussing the long Halloween arc from the comics before I moved on to discussing what we should expect to materialize out of that on the show come the fourth season. I also quoted Ben McKenzie, who stated during interviews at Comic-Con that the show will be doing two major comic book arcs on Season 4. The first arc he mentioned was the Long Halloween, in which I expect will run through the front half of the season and up until the show's winter break. The second arc, however, was Batman Year One, in which I expect will be coming to our screens around January and as the back half of the season starts. So let's talk the major bits related to the Batman Year One arc. For starters, Sarah Essen makes her comic book debut on the pages of this arc. Now I do realize she's been introduced on the show long ago as the captain of the GCPD before she died at the hands of Jerome on season 2, but the details on her comic book counterpart might be of some relevance. In the comics and on the pages of this arc in particular, she's a detective that Jim meets for the very first time as he's introduced to the world of Gotham. Soon enough though, a married James Gordon with a baby on the way finds himself having an affair with her. It doesn't last for long though, because he ends up having to end it as Commissioner Loeb tries to use his knowledge of it as blackmail against him. And before the arc was over, James Gordon has confessed it all to his wife Barbara, and Essen has left Gotham City for New York City. Beyond this arc though, and later on, post Gordon and Barbara's divorce, he ends up married to Essen before she dies years later at the hands of the Joker. But over the course of most of the Year One arc, and as I hinted moments ago, Barbara happens to be pregnant and goes to labor, giving birth to James Gordon Jr. Now James Jr. was freshly introduced for the very first time on the pages of this arc, and is one to grow to become a villain and an enemy of Batman. So generally speaking, what I'm thinking here is that the show needs to start working on speeding up the timetable on introducing the concept of family into the life of James Gordon. With the show's version of Barbara being incredibly hopeless and with Lee out of town, they might want to create an equivalent to the original comic book Sarah Essen and introduce her into the fold of the show. Unless they plan on bringing Lee back and stopping the whole let's bring them together to drive them away from one another over and over again. Now there are so many aspects to this arc that have already been done on the show. When the arc starts, Jim is arriving in Gotham for the first time ever, trying to figure out a way to work as the goody-two-shoes that he is amidst a corruption-infested GCPD and an even more corrupt Gotham City as a whole. That sequence even has Gillian Loeb as the corrupt commissioner we've seen make Jim Gordon's life a living hell over the course of season 1 and a bit on season 2, before he was forced by Penguin's henchman then, Victor Zsasz, to resign his post as a favor to Jim. Now as opposed to the Long Halloween arc, the Year One arc does not see Jim Gordon and Batman as friends or allies. Instead, they're both at two ends of the continuum, even though they're both working towards the same goal, making Gotham a better and safer city. On the Bruce Wayne front, he's also just been back to Gotham as the arc starts, trying to figure out a way to utilize all the training he's got so far into making the city a better place. He starts off with nothing but makeup to his name, changing his looks enough to be unrecognizable as the playboy of Gotham and one of the richest men in the city. But a few months later, he's already changing his approach and donning an initial version of the Batman costume. And 5 weeks into his appearance as the Bat of Gotham, people's belief in him being this giant bat moves into realizing he's more man than bat. And just like Gordon on the pages of this arc is actively looking for the vigilante with numerous counts of assault, Jim's going to be doing the same on the fourth season of the show as he has promised during Comic-Con. But speaking of the Long Halloween arc, this arc shares one significant aspect with it, Harvey Dent's hatred of Carmine Falcone. But instead of us seeing an older Gordon introducing Dent to Batman, we see Harvey Dent in league with Batman, helping him hide from Gordon at some point and utilizing his alliance with the vigilante of Gotham in working on taking down the baddies of the city. Kinda makes you wonder if Harvey Dent will be back on the season. The arc even sees Gordon suspecting Dent of being Batman as he's on the lookout for the vigilante of Gotham before his attention shifts to the man with the money, means, and reason to be Batman, Bruce Wayne. However though, those kind of hostile feelings towards the new vigilante in town change a bit at some point down the road, when Batman ends up saving an old woman from being run over by a truck driver before Gordon and Essen's eyes, the two of them manage to corner him, As he makes a run for it, he takes a bullet to his leg, and from there it all seems to go downhill for him. Essen calls it in. Loeb sends the SWAT team in, with orders to demolish the entire building Batman is hiding in. And it is right then and there that Gordon starts to doubt his very own motivations, get upset at how this is being handled, how Batman, whom he just watched save an old woman from death, could at any moment end up a corpse. But in no time, the bloody SWAT team that is now going through the rubble to find Batman is overwhelmed by the very man they're trying to find. But circling back to Bruce Wayne, both Gordon and Essen become obsessed with him being Batman. But even though he's being chased by Gordon, Bruce comes to the realization he cannot do this alone, that he needs an ally on the inside, and the only name that comes to his mind is that of Gordon. And by the time the arc is done, both Commissioner Loeb and Lieutenant Flass, who has been in league with him, are pretty much screwed. The first is forced to resign, just like the case was on the show, and the second is facing charges. By the time the arc is over as well, Bruce has saved Gordon's baby from imminent death at the hands of Falcone's goons, and Jim is no more after Batman. He starts viewing him as this new friend whose assistance he's about to ask for in dealing with this new player in town, the Joker. Now, when coming to think of what this arc had to present, here are a few stray comments and questions. Number one, I'm kind of wondering why Ben McKenzie stated that we'll be seeing the Long Halloween first, followed by Batman Year One. In a normal sequence of events, it should be the other way around. He might have misspoken, or they might just be planning on changing a lot when it comes to one or both arcs, probably the Long Halloween. Number 2. This arc sees both Bruce Wayne and Selina Kyle don their alter ego costumes for the very first time. It's like the prequel to both of them. The question here is, could that by any chance mean that we'll be seeing one or both of them get into a first initial kind of version of their comic book costumes? Number 3, will Jim get a long-lasting relationship? Will it be with Lee? Will it be with Barbara? Or will they just introduce a third woman into his life? Knowing how some people like to comment on the obvious, that would be a fourth if we count Valerie Vale in. But finally, number 4. With the involvement of both Harvey Dent and Carmine Falcone in both arcs, are they going to be playing major roles over the course of season 4? But with that being said, do let me know in the comments what your expectations are for the next season, what your answers are to these questions, and if you have any other predictions or expectations of your own. Let me know as well if you like the content of this video by slapping it a much appreciated like, and while you're at it, remember to subscribe and enable notifications. But until I see you next time, thank you all for tuning in, and have a perfect day.